Hello everyone. In today's topic, I would like to discuss you regarding the condition leptospirosis. So we'll mainly see the epidemiology of this disease. I'm dealing the content mainly related to the community health nursing. So coming to the history of this disease, so it was first isolated in the country Japan. It was isolated by Mr. Inada in 1915. And Mr. Weil, he described the clinical disease in the year 1886. That's what this leptospirosis is also known as, Weil's disease. And leptospirosis, it was known in China and Japan. It is called as rich harvest jaundice or autumn fever. So this is the history regarding the disease leptospirosis. So coming to this topic leptospirosis, just what is this leptospirosis means? It is a zoonosis, it is an environmental disease, as well as it is an occupational disease. So it was mainly occurred from the animal infection from different types of serotypes. So these serotypes are belonging to the leptospira, which were known as spirochetes. So these are mainly transmitted to human beings in various environmental conditions. Coming to the epidemiological factors here, first we'll discuss regarding the agent factor. So mainly we have two types of species. First one is enterogens and second one is biflexia. So in enterogens, they are pathogenic, and biflexia, these are saprophytic. The Leptospira serovirus predominantly present in India are L. ichthyohemorrhagae. So these are the agent factors. Coming to the source of infection here, the source of infection is the urine of infected animals. Whatever the excreted urine is there, this is the major source for the source of infection. Coming to the reservoirs here, we have animal reservoirs. In that, we have rodents. These rodents include mice, rats, and voles. And this domestic animal, they include cattle, sheep, goat, and water buffalo, pigs, horses, dogs. They may act as a carrier. Coming to the rats here, in rats we have two types of reservoirs, means important types of reservoirs. So in those rat species we have R. norvegicus and Mus musculus. These are the two species which are acting as a major reservoir for this disease leptospirosis. Coming to the host factors here, if you take age and sex, so males are more prone to get this disease than females, as they are having greater occupational exposure. And human infection is very accidental, and what is the age group which is frequently affected is 20 to 30 years. Coming to the high risk groups here, we have agriculture workers, we have fishermen, and we have sphere workers, and we have lorry drivers and masons. So these are the persons who are having this infection, means these are the high risk groups for this infection. What are the favorable conditions which are favoring the transmission of this disease? Means drainage, congestion and water lodging, soil sanitation, soil temperature and seasonal variation. So it starts at the onset of rainy season and declines as the rains recede. Why? Because during the rainy season there is more stagnation. Next one is heavy rains and floods, poor housing, limited water supply, and inadequate method of waste disposal. All these are the favorable conditions for the transmission of the disease leptospirosis. Coming to the mode of transmission here, how this infection is being spreaded, means we have two types of transmission. We have generic rodent transmission model and we have generic animal transmission model. So in generic rodent transmission model, the disease is being spread from the asymptomatic rodent carriers. In case of generic animal transmission model, the disease is being spread from the wild animals. So from these wild animals, it can directly occur to the human being. If it is coming from the rodents, these rodents are capable of infecting the soil as well as water. So when this contaminated soil and this contaminated water is consumed by the healthy person, or when his cuts or any kind of abrasions which are present on the body are exposed to this contaminated water, then there is more chance of transmission of infection from contaminated water to the person, as well as more chance of infection from the infection from the animals to the man. So this is how the mode of transmission is taking place. Simple. It is very simple here. If you see the rodents, all time they may remain asymptomatic. So whenever these wild animals or any livestock is coming contact with the rodents, there are more chances for the transmission of the disease. If the livestock is infected, if the rodents come in contact with the livestock, then there are more chances for the rodent to get infected. Once these infected, these cattle and these domestic animals, these are capable of transmitting the infection to the man. In the same way, the rodents which they are present, whenever they are coming in contact with the soil or water, these are capable of transferring the organism into soil and water. So whenever a person is drinking the water, consuming the infected water, or whenever a person is having some abrasions or cuts on the surface of the skin, if this contaminated water is coming in contact with the surface of the skin, then the person may land up in the infection. So this is the mode of transmission. So there are three types: direct contact, indirect contact, and droplet infection. So direct man-to-man infection is very rare here. Mainly we are having indirect contact and droplet infection. Coming to the incubation here, incubation period is about 10 days and it is having an average range of 4 to 20 days. Coming to the clinical features, we have two types of clinical features that have been described here. We have clinical features are mainly of two types: ectoric and anectoric. So anectoric leptospirosis and ectoric leptospirosis. If you see the anectoric leptospirosis, it is the milder form of the disease, and the patients will have symptoms such as fever and myalgia, and they do not have any kind of jaundice, and almost 90% of the patients have this type of illness. Coming to the icterus here, what do you mean by icterus? Yellowish discoloration of eyes, subconjunctiva, and the tongue and the mucosa and the other parts of the body is known as an icteric condition, where it is a condition where we can observe the yellowish discoloration of these parts. So here, if a patient is in icteric state, it indicates the severe form of the disease, and it is mainly characterized by jaundice. So this jaundice is usually associated with the involvement of other organs, and about 5 to 10% of the patients will have this type of clinical manifestations. Most of the time in leptospirosis, patients will be an anectoric in condition, but about 5 to 10% of the patient, these patients will enter into the ectoric leptospirosis condition. Coming to the signs and symptoms of this anectoric, you can observe fever and chills, myalgia of calf will be there, abdominal and lumbosacral muscles will have pain, and conjunctival suffusion we can see, headache will be there, which is throbbing, and it will be most of the time in the frontal region, and renal infestation can be observed. So you can observe mild proteinuria, and you even in some cases we can see cast cells also, and pulmonary infestation may be also present. You can see the cough and pain in the chest, you can also observe the hemoptysis, and petechial hemorrhage also may be present. This petechial hemorrhage means nothing but bleeding from the tiny spots which are present on the skin. So this petechial hemorrhage, it can occur even in the condition dengue also. So you have to go for differential diagnosis whenever you are doing it. These are the petechiae, and here we can see conjunctival suffocation, and these are also some examples for petechiae. Coming to the next clinical feature, that is icteric condition. In icteric condition, all the signs and symptoms will be as same as those anectoric condition. The only thing that you can observe in this icteric condition are jaundice, means increased levels of the bilirubin in the body, and also we will observe high temperatures. We will observe high temperature, which are compared to anectoric condition. In icteric condition, these fevers can be more danger and more severe. Coming to the organ involvement here. So what are all the organs that are involved during the disease leptospirosis? So the organs which are involved are: kidneys are involved, liver is involved, and lungs are involved, heart is involved, and blood and brain is involved. So whenever an organ is involved in this condition, these are the signs and symptoms that you can observe. So if it is a kidney, you can see the decreased urine output and features of uremia. If it is liver, you will find out jaundice and hepatomegaly. In case of lung, in case of involvement of the organ lung, you will observe cough, hemoptysis, dyspnea, and there will be increased respiration rate as well as basal Krebs. In case of heart, you can observe hypotension and irregular pulse. If it is blood, you can see bleeding tendencies. As I have shown you in the previous slide, you can observe the petechiae. You can observe the signs and symptoms of petechiae. And in case of brain, you will see altered consciousness with neck rigidity. The persons will have neck rigidity as it was observed. So, these are the signs and symptoms based upon the organ involvement. So, what are the clinical signs and symptoms here? Mainly, we have two types of clinical symptoms. The first one is anectric condition and second one is icteric condition. In anectric condition, we are having signs and symptoms such as fever, which is having chills also, and there will be myalgia of cuff muscles, abdominal muscles and lumbosacral muscles, and you will have conjunctival suffusion. We are having headache, which is thrombing in nature and it is occurring only on the frontal part, and we have renal infestation. Mainly you can observe mild proteinuria, and we are having pulmonary conditions, and we can observe the petechial hemorrhage also. In case of icteric condition, jaundice will be there and remaining all other symptoms are in a normal manner, and you can observe high temperatures compared to the anectric condition. If there are organ involvement is there, so the organ, based on the organ involvement, the signs and symptoms will vary in this manner. Coming to the burden of the disease here, this is a disease which is having the potential capacity to cause an epidemic. So, in an annual incidence, if you take in the temperature climates, in the temperate areas, per 1 lakh population, you can observe the cases about 0.1 to 1. In case of humid and tropical condition, you can observe the cases that is from 10, even more also. So, this is the disease burden when it is compared to the temperature areas. Coming to the most widespread zoonosis here. So, leptospirosis, it is a treatable disease. So, whenever you observe this disease, whenever you find a case with leptospirosis, if you are able to treat it with the correct antibiotic, you can prevent the disease and you can cure the disease accurately. Coming to the world status here. So, 63% of the cases are seen in the Americas. So, mainly the countries including Brazil, Nicaragua and Argentina. You can observe 63% of the leptospirosis cases in these regions. And 15% of the cases are seen in the Western Pacific. And 14% of the cases are seen in the Southeast Asian region. And 0.8% of the cases are seen in the Europe. And rest of the cases we can see in Africa and Eastern Mediterranean areas. So, coming to the status in India, so since it is the disease which is mainly transmitted through water, contaminated water, most of the coastal districts in India are affected with this disease, leptospirosis. So, you can see in Gujarat, Maharashtra, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, Karnataka, Andamans and Orissa. So, these are the coastal districts in India. Since it is a waterborne disease and it is mainly coming from contaminated water, these states are mostly having high risk groups. So, possible outbreaks can be reported in these type of areas. So, if you check out the previous outbreaks, we will have a clear idea here. See, if you see here, in the year 1995 to 1998, there was an outbreak in the United States. And this outbreak was only pertained to the country United States. But if you take India, in the year 1999, in the state Orissa, there was a cyclone. So, immediately after the cyclone has gone, they have seen the outbreak of this disease, leptospirosis. And again, if you take other countries, in Indonesia, in the area called Jakarta, there was a flood which had occurred in the year 2002. So, after the flooding was finished, they have seen the outbreak of the disease, leptospirosis. And if you come to our state Gujarat, here in mainly in the South Gujarat, they have seen an outbreak in the year 2002 to 2005. And in Mumbai and Maharashtra, mainly whenever the flood had occurred in the year 2002 and 2005, in these areas they have seen the outbreak of the cases. And if you see in Sri Lanka also, after 2008 flooding, they have seen the outbreak of leptospirosis. And in Philippines, again, after the cyclone has struck here, post cyclone, they have observed the outbreak. And if you see outbreak in canyoning athletes in the Caribbean island of Martin Q, they have seen the outbreak in the year 2011. So these are the outbreaks which had occurred due to the leptospirosis. So mainly the guidelines for prevention and control of leptospirosis are given by National Institute of Communicable Diseases, that is Zoonotic Division 2006. So what are the guidelines here? Mainly first they have to define the case. If an acute febrile illness case is present with headache, myalgia and prostration associated with these type of symptoms, means associated with conjunctival suffusion, meningeal irritation and jaundice, hemorrhage, cardiac arrhythmia or cardiac failure, in these conditions you can say the person, you can suspect the case for leptospirosis. How you can classify the case, means we are classifying mainly into two types, suspected and confirmed. So if a case that is compatible with clinical description, means if you observe these type of signs and symptoms in a case, you can confirm it, you can say it as a suspected. Whenever you observe a suspect case, if you confirm it with the possible laboratory test, if you confirm it with the proper clinical evidence, then you can say the person is having leptospirosis in a evidence based manner. Next one is laboratory criteria for diagnosis. So how you have to go for laboratory diagnosis, means we have to collect and transport the serum in a sample. Labeling and transportation of the sample have to be done in an accurate manner, and collection of clinical samples for isolation of leptospirosis is mainly done from blood, urine and CSF. And you can also collect from the other tissues which are like autopsy tissues, such as liver and kidney. Why? Because as I said, there is organ involvement also. So if you check here, what are all the organs involving in this disease? Kidney is involving, liver is involving, lung, heart, blood and brain. So these are all the organs which are involving in the disease. So during autopsy, if you want to have a clear cut diagnosis, then you can go for the diagnosis of those removed tissues. Coming to this serological diagnosis here, mainly they are doing ELISA test, nothing but enzyme linked immunosorbent assay test, and they are going for rapid immunodiagnostics, which is based upon the IgM detection. So we have treatment of leptospirosis in mainly three levels: PHC level they are doing, CHC level they are doing, and territory level they are doing. So if you see at PHC, CHC and district hospitals in the endemic areas, so clinical suspect, if you suspect the case, then you are giving the treatment like tablet doxycycline 100 mg twice daily for 7 days. If the patient is having mild disease or if the rapid immunodiagnostic test was positive, then you are going for penicillin. We are giving crystalline penicillin 20 lakh international units every 6th hourly for adults. If it is children, we are giving 2 to 4 lakhs units per kg body weight for 7 days. And if the features of organ dysfunction are present, we are referring them for higher center. So whenever the disease is progressing into severe states, whenever we are observing petechiae, whenever you are observing icterus and jaundice, so and whenever you are observing cardiac arrhythmias, whenever the fever is becoming more uncontrollable, in such times we are referring the case for higher centers. So treatment at medical college or tertiary center, first we have two step treatment. First they will give chemotherapy, then they will go for organ specific care. So in chemotherapy, they are giving tablet doxycycline 100 mg twice daily for 7 days. If they are children, they are giving capsule amoxicillin or ampicillin for twice daily for 7 days. If in case organ or specific care, we are giving organ specific and symptomatic treatment. So what are all the international initiatives that had taken place, means? So the International Leptospirosis Society, which is called as ILS, it was formed in the year 1994, and it was to promote knowledge upon the disease through mainly through organization of regional and global leptospirosis meetings. If you come to in India, a pilot project was conducted on the control of leptospirosis, and it was approved as a new initiative in the 11th 5-year plan. and it was planned, it was done mainly in the 5 endemic states, and they have the main objective to reduce the morbidity and mortality of the disease in these project areas. And proposal for leptospirosis control was kept in the 12th 5 year. Coming to the prevention and control of this disease, leptospirosis. So we have to protect the people against the coming to the prevention and control of this disease, leptospirosis, we have to educate the people to get protected against the contagion of available means contagious objects. Then you have to go for health education, you have to vaccinate the animals, you should go for rodent control and mapping of water bodies for establishing proper drainage system. And what are all the health impacts that had occurred on the developmental projects? And leptospirosis should be made reportable disease in all endemic areas. Leptospirosis, it should be made a reportable disease in all endemic states, because it is a disease which is having the capability to spread from one person to another person. So we must need a proper surveillance for the control of this disease, leptospirosis. And the last thing you can do is chemoprophylaxis. So coming to the vaccination of animals, vaccination for animals chart is available here. You can take a screenshot of this picture and you can take down the notes. This is regarding leptospirosis. And you can go and search for control measures also if you want. Thank you so much. Thanks for listening. If you like the content, please like, share and subscribe the channel. Thank you so much.